basically have two different time signatures going on at the same time that over time equate to the same pulse. So I'm playing a certain polyrhythm being this. And then Troy's playing a rhythm that is five over that. So it sounds like together. Time they equal the same rhythm. I just really enjoyed that syncopation more than anything else, and then Troy came up with his part on top of it, so it ended up being a polyrhythm. We had those two together.
Yeah,
so,
it's just something that happened.
Yeah, more than anything else.
Mostly an accident.
Yeah.
Thank you.
well, there's only two of us, you know?
Yeah.
So, and I think it's the most direct to have this type of communication when you're being able to see each other, you know, being able to communicate with each other. Because I think a lot of our communication is obviously unspoken because, you know, we're not using words per se. So, you know, maybe the height of my hand.
If I can see his hands, I know what he's doing.
Yeah.
You know?
And I can cue things that way. He can cue things that way. Yeah. And it allows us just more control when we're facing this way. It's so much more direct. You know, you don't have to strain yourself to do anything, you know.
And I think visually it's the thing that makes sense.
Yeah,
exactly. Especially since as of yet we don't have vocals. We don't really have to worry about being facing toward a crowd, you know.
Yeah.
They can see us both working.
Exactly.
I never really played with Caleb that much during school.
No, uh-uh.
This is just since we've graduated.
Exactly, very recently. Since Troy lived in Lancaster and then moved to Columbus, and since I moved to Columbus for doing student teaching, that's when we really started playing with each other. This past fall was when the idea came together, and now we've really just been pushing for it now the past while.